So when Prey released last year, I absolutely was enamored with it. It was this sci-fi, psychological, horror thriller, RPG that just kind of encompassed so many player choices and weight and with the narrative and what could occur. Now, I had played Prey a long time ago. I knew this was a total revamp, renewing of the series, and I just wasn't very excited for it. But when I got my hands on it, I just couldn't stop playing it. Like, this game really pulled me into its sci-fi, space futuristic world, and its storyline was really interesting, and I won't give away the end plot, but it was pretty neat what ends up happening. So when there was rumors that there was going to be a Prey DLC on the moon, well, my feelers were a little bit peaked, if you know what I'm saying. The big surprise though was at E3 when they showed the trailer for the new content and then said, hey, it's out right now, go download it. I was not prepared. As a matter of fact, I forgot about it with all the E3 hype and things going on, and then in my inbox, I got an email from Bethesda saying, hey, here's the Prey DLC. Want to check it out? So, of course, I had to go right into it. That said, what I've played so far, I'm extremely into this game. Like, a lot. So you play as this character that's actually on a small little research vessel, and they're getting data from people that were actually on the moon. And you're using that data to run a simulation to kind of figure out what happened on the moon. And again, it's set up very much like the original game. You know, it's very moody, it's atmospheric, and there's a lot of choice. But there's one huge difference. Roguelike mechanics and dying a lot. Yes, in this DLC, you're going to find that you're just going to die a lot, and that is all a part of the process. As you take a character, you're going to go through this environment, and the key aspect here is to try to escape. Now, as you play as one character and make an escape, you get to play as another character and try to make an escape, but a different way. So no two games actually come out feeling the same because A, you can't escape the prior way, and B, things completely different happen every time you play and die and restart because it's a simulation. So sometimes enemies get harder because the simulation keeps running on and on and on, and eventually the simulation crashes, and then you kind of have to start all over with the difficulty. But as you get these characters and you unlock certain story elements in their game, you will end up unlocking more characters, and then you can finally make a run through all the characters to try and get out alive in one solid felt swoop. It's an intense game. It's a very interesting mechanic because it is a very Groundhog's Day feeling where you're just kind of going on and on and on. But, you know, you get mechanics that you can learn, like your abilities, and you get things that you can end up reusing in the runs, but then again, it has to reboot, and then you kind of go through this whole thing again. And it can be frustrating at times, because honestly, sometimes you're just going to be like, I died again, and I don't want to go, oh, why is it happening to me? But that aside, I mean, if you can get into this mechanic and the way that the game is presented, it's a really neat idea, and it really plays with the whole simulation aspect, which I think is just brilliant. And if you play the original and beat it, you can kind of know why I think they went with this route. Now, I will say I wasn't really expecting a roguelike game. I'm not a huge fan of those titles, but this one does seem to kind of put its claws into me a little bit more. Maybe it's because I like the original game so much. Maybe it's because they still do the amazing atmosphere that Prey original did. I mean, it's just on there thick. The story, the mystery, the setting. This doesn't feel like a cheap DLC, but it also feels like a completely different DLC. It's not just a standard, like, go through a narrative and just do the same thing and just kind of get to an end from linear point A to point B. With the randomization and the reruns that you're doing, things just completely change, and a run is never quite like the last run, and except for death, because you're going to die a lot, and, you know, that's just the name of the game. Overall, I would say that the DLC for Prey is absolutely worth it if you like the original game, and even if you don't like rogue games, you still might find a reason to want to play this, if just for the story and the setting alone. But I will say, I have to be in a particular mood to play this type of game, and when I get frustrated, it hits, and it hits hard, and I'm kind of like, okay, I'm done, I want to put it away, maybe I'll try again the next day. But anyway, that's just been a quick look at the Prey DLC. If you've played it, what do you think of it? Are you enjoying the new style of gameplay? Of course, it still retains its first-person elements and atmosphere, but again, it's kind of really broken down into a completely different experience than the prior game, so I'm digging it. I like that they kind of took a little bit of a step outside their comfort zone in ways. and giving us a unique thing to experience and go through. But again, it might not be for everyone, and if you're looking for a really heavy, like, story-driven narrative RPG, well, it's there and it's not, so it's kind of in between. But overall, the quality on this one is high up, and I'd highly recommend it. So anyway, that's all the time I have. Thank you for watching, and until the next video, this is Justin signing off. Oh, shit, there's a mimic over there. Oh, God! Ah!